You know what? No intro today. Boom, we are straight up going to Poland. Poland. We have received a new nice focus tree, you know, so yeah. We'll do some monarchist shit today. Because why the fuck not? I will show you a secret monarch that you can get as Poland. And you know, we here don't have that big of an industry, but it is something to work with. And also we need to get ready for these peasants here. No workers revolution today, boys. And now, after assembling Regency Council, we change color and name of our country, and now our ruler is a chair. So yeah, we just continue to fulfill the 5th November Act, and soon we will pick our ruler. And now we just have to wait for a few events, and in the meanwhile, we will just go for the agrarian reform so we can shoot all the rebelling peasants peacefully. And now we have here our first king event, we will refuse it. Soon you will see why. A Habsburg candidate, we will still say no. And finally we don't have to worry about instability in Poland. Yeah, it's best to get rid of this as soon as possible. And now, sexy Michael, we will have to decline. I'm sorry, mate. And now we get an option for the Cossack king, and we will decline again. You may be asking why I'm declining all these kings. Well, it's because, as you can see, here are 4 paths for all the kings, and if we refuse them all again, we will get a new secret path right here. After making our country stable, we will just develop it up as much as possible. And again, saying no to the candidates. Ah yes, we have 9 out of 11 factories in use. Wink, wink. You know, maybe our country was stabilized from those peasant workers, but now I will destabilize it by clamping down on Danzig. It's now Gdansk. And now, last no to the Cossack king. Oh yeah, baby, this is just like the good old Hong Kong. And now we can choose a special option, Anastasia Romanov as our ruler of Poland. Why not? Oh yeah, fulfill the 5th November Act is complete. Now, we got a nice white collar and Anastasia Romanov in charge. That's right, boys. We have a new king and it's a little bit long, I know. Now, as you can see, we have a new part of our focus tree, so now we will invite exiled nobles. So yeah, basically this path leads to Pan-Slavism. And now we can ban the Nazi party and rename Danzig to Gdansk. Let's be spicy, boys. Oh yeah, now it's Gdansk. We will probably still give it to Germans because I want to focus on the Soviets, but still, a fed W. Oh yeah, baby, let's go for that Pan-Slavic revanchism. That will add Polish revanchism as a national spirit, but we don't talk about that. You know what I really love? That I can now do a little Anschluss over Lithuania. Yeah, just let me get my whole army here. Just in case, we are very peaceful, you know. But just in case. Also, not to forget to mention, if you get your truck production up, you want to always switch these little bad boys to trucks, so you will get your divisions better supplied. Okay, now we will just wait. In the meanwhile, we will demand Yugoslavian subjugation that will for sure help when we are distant over 2 countries from them, but okay. Oh yeah, we get the Lithuania and their whole army. Yippee. You know, I don't really have high hopes for this, but yeah, we get war goal, but I don't feel like we will be able to get here. Anyway, let's demand Slovakia before the Germans can get it. Oh yeah, this is pretty nice. Expansion goes brrrr. Now it's time to move to the Baltics. Oh yeah, and I just noticed that we can get rid of this pesky embargo and go for export economy. Now you can buy my shitty products. So yeah, here goes nothing, just our little XP sponges. Yeah, we just quickly go in and not even care about the supplies. And now that we are a long boy, we will prepare for a war with the Soviet Union. You know, but before we go to war with the Soviet Union, we will declare war on Hungary because they are fascist and nobody will guarantee them. And then we can even get our Yugoslavia. Now I feel like I will do a big pro-gamer move. I will declare war on Hungary and also Yugoslavia at the same time. I feel strong. Oh shit. Yeah, I thought this might be a possibility. This is over. Oh yeah, I created somewhat of a big axis, not gonna lie. You know, let's pretend that that never happened and we will all just go by our days, as usual. Wink, wink. Oh no, what has Romanov criticized for weak foreign policy? I know that this is about that expired war goal on Hungary, but... Man, didn't you see what I have already conquered? Oh yeah, baby, let's get spicy here. This is what I've been waiting for and preparing my whole army. Oh yeah, this is the classical Polish experience, boys and girls. Getting fisted by two sides. You know, fuck it, Soviets justify against me, I will justify against them with my focus here. I'm not dealing with the Germans just yet. Here you go, just for now. Oh yeah, I can demand Pomerania from the Germans for some reason, so let's give it a try, why the fuck not? Who'd have guessed? Not really, this is not even surprising, but it would be funny if they agreed to. Oh yeah, and the Soviets just declared war on me. Good thing is that I have been preparing my little cipher here, so... And Britain is guaranteeing my independence. This might not look that good. Oh yeah, it seems like that we will have to retreat. Let's abandon our position. Let's also try to save as many people as possible. And also let's sabotage some things here, cause we can scorch the earth. So hopefully the land the Soviets get will be pretty worthless for them, at least for a while. So yeah, this is just my new favorite feature of the game. Oh yeah, we just lost few divisions here, doesn't matter. The most of the army is safe. So yeah, Polska jeszcze nie zginęła. So yeah, pretty much see you after few years of intense micromanagement. But yeah, we should be fine. As long as we keep our spirits up. And we don't run out of alcohol. So yeah, after a while it's not looking that bad because we have already killed over 1 million Soviets. At least something, I guess. We are slowly preparing for our march to the Soviet lands, but we still have some time. Ooh, now I really like that I can see that the Soviets are forcing attacks on me. That's very cute. Also, you have new defensive plans here for 50 political power, so yeah, we will use that too. Yeah, the Soviets have no chance against us. Poland is nicely pimped up in this new DLC, I have to say. You know, I really like how I can witness Yugoslavia being maliciously murdered by Axis, but no, I won't step in, I'm not in the position to fight Germany right now. After killing almost 2 million Soviets, I think it's time to do a little pushing and trolling. Oh yeah, baby. Let's massacre some good old Soviets. Oh yeah, killing Soviets is full-time job now. I mean, it always has been kinda. And the heroic Polish soldiers are going to massacre yet another Soviet pocket. This is just all too nice. It's going slowly, but we are winning, and that's the important thing here. You know, slowly but surely I'm winning against the Soviets, but now it's not 1v1. Now they created Iranian communist authorities, so they have a little front here too. So because of that, I feel like it should be much easier to push here. They're just going like a knife through butter through these Soviet defenses, quote unquote. Holy fucking shit, this is running so slow. This is speed 5, by the way. I just wanted to show you my great instill command here, but I will be waiting at least an hour to close it by the looks of it. Oh shit. But finally now you can enjoy a thick bloody encirclement. Oh ho ho, this will hurt Mr. Stalin now. Like for real, this is just too beautiful to be true. Always a great satisfaction. Oh, and finally the Germans came into the mix. You see, the typical Germans will try to claim Polish man's work. SMH shaking my head. You know, I feel like it's time to finally do some little pushing of our own. Yeah, I mean, after encircling so many Soviet divisions, this should be all fine. This is a very pretty nice invasion of the Soviet Union. I was even able to make my own collaboration government after giving some under-table handjobs. So yeah, this is looking pretty good. You know, this is the real power of Poland, getting Lend-Lease from Vichy France and British Raj. I'm just playing both sides so I come on top. And the Polish quest for world peace just continues with slaughtering another Soviets in our pockets. This is just a wholesome fun for the whole family, not gonna lie. Yeah, this is just never-ending story of many encirclements in Russia. Hurrah! Krim Nash. Now, before we get into this city, we want to do a little event here. I know it's console comment, but I don't fucking care. You want to see something funny, you will see something funny. Just give it a moment till we get to Moscow. And finally, after what feels like an eternity, we are in Moscow, baby. Oh, whoa, what have we found on Mrs. Anastasia? Ooh, NKVD archives, she's not part of Romanov family. Well then, we need to replace her with the worthy ruler for Poland. All hail our new king Wojciech. Yeah, so basically this is how Poland can get a bear to rule the whole country. I love this so fucking much. Worth the pain of getting into 101 with the Soviets. So yeah, now we just have to slowly end this war with the Soviets and proclaim Panslavia under Wojciech. Yeah, this is just too based to be true. You know, I really love this picture. Antonescu is talking to a bear about giving him guns.
Ei, respingem, domnule!
Wholesome times indeed. Oh yeah, empty Stalingrad goes brrr. You know, this war is a pain in the ass, not because of the new supplies or new combat system, but how slow it runs. But hey, at least these nice encirclements are keeping my spirit up. Yeah, I have massacred a lot of people here, but I'm winning, so it doesn't count as a war crime. This is actually painful at this speed. I have been sitting here for a while and it's not fun. Not at all. It's worse than cock and ball torture. But like, fucking finally, just need to wait until midnight. That will take like 5 years to go there. And finally it's time to take what is mine. So yeah, I just took what's mine. And now I feel like it's time to proclaim Slavic unity with a bear in charge. Crazy times we live in. Oh yeah, and we got kicked out of the Allies. And Britain still guarantees my independence, so that's at least nice. So yeah, this is pretty pogus. We got a new flag and a new color and a lot of manpower. And a lot of new factories, so yeah, I'm just gonna get ready to fuck some shit up. Now, after I have built a massive army, my bear ruler got the masculine urge to march towards the Berlin. So now we are just going to go to war with the Axis and see how it goes. I have a good feeling about this. Oh yeah, now it's time to destroy the Germans. And we will do everything that is in our power to burn this country to the ground. So yeah, the first things first, we need Gdańsk back. Thank you very much for keeping an eye on for that territory, but daddy is home. Oh yeah, you want me again? Okay. So yeah, I got pushed a little, but we have this nicely under control, or at least I hope. You see some new German pockets. At least the Allies are helpful and did a D-Day. Yippee. But yeah, the southern front nicely holds, so we are grinding them pretty hard here. So yeah, our bear leader still has the urge to burn down the Berlin. We will soon get there, hopefully, before this whole front just collapses. Yeah, that's a possibility too. For some fucking reason, Turkey declared war on my little Iran, so yeah, we have another new front to worry about. Great. Fucking great. Masculine urge to massacre everyone in this city. You know, finally I can say that this war nicely turned into our favor. Fucking finally. Oh yeah, it is time to push, baby. I'm only doing this because a bear told me to slaughter them all. And message for the Führer. Cope. Everyone in the Führer's bunker is on that copium. They will be coping very hard. Oh yeah, I kinda forgot that the Turkey was still in this war, so yeah, this is not a good look, I know. but I feel like we'll be able to beat them back. Important thing is that we are almost at the gates of Berlin now, and we know that Adolf is on that good old copium. How does it feel when a bear beats you fair and square? Oh yes, baby. The fall of Berlin is here. Indeed, the Polish juggernaut cannot be stopped, maybe by Turkey. Oh yeah, it is easier and easier to get nice fig encirclements. Bye bye, everyone. Kurva match, this is just like the good old war against the Soviets. Oh, I just got the flashbacks now. Oh yeah, I feel like the Germans are now broken when they don't even have enough divisions to hold our front, so it's time for the big attack. But yeah, this is the slow death of German Reich and its goons. Finally, this will get a lot easier from now on. Oh yeah, Spain just committed suicide, welcome aboard. You know, I still need to figure out how the fuck the combat system works. Yeah, that will take a while. Oh yeah, and Palermo got nuked, I think, by the Americans, so yeah. No more mafia movies, I guess. You know, I just hate how you have to capitulate Vichy France here in Africa. You're just pointlessly prolonging this bloody conflict for no good reason. Like, really, there is no way back. So yeah, I feel like this is a fair treaty. A bear can paint maps very nicely. So yeah, if you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to leave a dislike. And if you didn't like it, don't forget to leave a like. Anyway, tell me in the comments, what do you think about this new DLC? And also, don't forget to subscribe, because we are nearing 100,000 subscribers. And when we hit that goal, I'm going to quit YouTube. Maybe. And as always, big thanks goes to my channel members. Their names are in the description and on the screen right now. And a special thanks goes to Bryce Law for being the highest channel member.